Hi there, it's Lullaby for another video. This time it's not a reaction, it's my first story time. So as you can see, I have specific glasses, I have a beanie, I have a shirt and a necklace with a symbol that you might have noticed. This is a symbol of my favorite band called 30 Seconds to Mars. This is gonna be the story time where I explain how I met Jared Leto and the two other members of the band. These glasses, they actually are very specific and important to me because Jared Leto put them on his face twice. So I'm gonna remove them now. I don't wanna scratch them or anything. I'm gonna talk mostly about the first time I met them. The second time was more recently with my mother. It was just like the first time for meet and greet with the band at one of their concerts. The first time was really special. Nothing much happened this second time. We just took a picture with them, had a few questions, just like most meet and greets happen. But the first time was a long story, so I'm gonna explain it to you right now. So, first time I met them was on 17th July in 2014. I had just turned 19. I had a friend who went to quite a few meet and greets before, and she'd met Jared Leto a few times. She told him that she was organizing a bus from Belgium to Vienne in France to see them in their concert in Vienne, and I took part in that bus. So I went with 20 other Echelon to that concert with the bus, and they had a sign that said the Belgian bus is here, so that Jared and the other members could notice us. Unfortunately that time Shannon wasn't there, so it was just Jared and Tomo, but I'll get to that point later on. Before Jared arrived, I had already explained how I loved them. Back then it was for 9 years. I'd been a fan of the band. I was quite emotional because it was the first celebrity that I would meet, and it was very important to me because the band means a lot to me. So yeah, so I was really overwhelmed, which is why when we were sitting around the stage waiting for them to arrive, when someone said, "Is it him?" I turned around and I saw Jared standing 5 meters away from us, and I literally started crying. Like, oh my God, it's really him. He's 5 meters away from me. He's real. Before that, I hadn't really realized what was happening. I had already seen them twice in concerts, but I was like 15 meters away, and it's not the same when someone is quite far to realize that they are in the same room as you. So this time he was really close and I was like, he is real, this is really happening, this is not a dream, like this is actually going to happen. So then went on the Q&A. So the guys welcomed us and they asked us to go around the little catwalk that was in the middle of the stage. So me and my friends went over on the other side, and they stayed like 3 meters away from the catwalk, and I was like, nah, I'm gonna get a little closer. So I went over and I was literally like 30 centimeters away from the edge of the stage, and I had those glasses on. I didn't have these glasses, I didn't need eyeglasses before, so I just had these, and to see properly, because as you can see it's filled, I had just put them over my head, and I was like completely in awe right at their feet. So they were standing on the catwalk and I was just below them. At some point, people were asking questions. I didn't really have specific questions, so I just listened. And since we were 200 people, I knew I would barely get a chance to ask something, and I wanted others to have that chance. Tomo was being goofy and funny. At some point, Jared, who had sunglasses on, turns towards where I was, and he goes, "Oh, I love your glasses." But didn't realize he was talking to me. With the sunglasses, I couldn't see specifically where he was looking, So I looked around and I noticed that no one but me had glasses. So I turned to Jared and he's literally crouching a little bit in front of me. And I don't know how, but I somehow managed to speak to him, but I was literally like automatic mode. I didn't even register what was happening. So I just talked to him and I was like, oh yeah, these glasses, a fan bought them and planned a few so that a few echelon could get these with different colors and patterns. And one of these, the white ones with just the red heart, you put them on during the concert in Lille, so in France, in February. And so I handed the glasses to him and he puts them over his sunglasses. I wasn't registering what was happening. Literally, I was dreaming, or I don't know. I was out of it. Then he takes them off, takes his sunglasses off, and puts my glasses back on his face. And I still didn't resist what was happening. I was like, yeah, cool, huh? And so he goes to hand them back to me, but he pretends like he's gonna throw them. And I'm like, oh my God. I freeze, thinking that they're gonna break or something. Of course, he was joking. So he hands them back to me. And then he goes, okay, let's do the line to do the signings. I take the glasses and I'm like, wait, did this actually happen? Was that actually real? That's the moment when the penny drops and I'm just like holding the glasses to my heart. And I'm like, oh my God, Jared, talk to me. He took my glasses, he put them on his face twice. I mean, what? I'm usually not someone who's really emotional, but I broke. Like, I literally was suffocating, crying. I had trouble breathing, I was shaking. Like, even my friends around the other echelon who came with me, they were like, hey, calm down, what's happening? Breathe, breathe. And I was literally crying. I kind of lost control a bit. Like, I'm not someone who goes over emotional like that, but it was something so unexpected, something that I had dreamed of for so long, to talk to Jared Leto, someone who I admire, who was a really important person, an artist to me, someone whose art has amazing messages. So I was really, really emotional about it. That's something that I'm not really ashamed of, but I kind of feel like I wouldn't react the same way at this age. Like, I was going through some stuff back then, so maybe that's why I reacted that extremely. But seriously, it was an amazing experience, and it's only the beginning. So he puts my glasses on, he gives them back, we go on a line, I'm trying to breathe, I'm calming down, and since we are 200 people, the line is long, and so the wait is long. I prepare myself, I calm down, I put the glasses on again, of course, so he recognizes me, and I breathe, and I'm like, okay, he liked my glasses, maybe later on for the picture, I can hand them to him, so he puts them on for the picture, which is what happened. But before that, for the autograph, he noticed again my glasses. So since there were so many people, they had to be quick, so they were like scribbling their signature. So I wanted him to sign the Love That's Faith and Dream cover. So it's only Jared and Tomo's signature, of course, since Shannon wasn't there. He signs, he looks up slightly, and then realizes it was me with my glasses. And he's like, ah, cool glasses. I'm like, thank you. And I go to walk away to let other people get their signature. And then I hear him call for Rennie, so one of the assistants, and he asks her to take a picture of me with the glasses. So I'm like, are you being serious right now? I have a lag, like a glitch. Literally, I'm glitching. I felt stupid afterwards. I go over there, I'm like, with the glasses like this. Then I put them on, then I put them over my head. And she takes like 3 or 4 pictures of me with the glasses in my hands, on my face, on my head. I don't know why, but I literally had my brain go off. And maybe it's Jared's aura maybe it's me who was literally in a bad moment, like dealing with so much stuff, and I was overwhelmed with the emotions and with so many people around. And I don't know, I just kind of glitched. I realized only afterwards that Jared had asked to take me in picture. I mean, okay, I'm not saying that I'm special or anything. I'm saying that, oh my God, Jared loves me, he noticed me, you know, but it's still something special because in a crowd of 200 people, he didn't ask many people to take specific pictures. He didn't ask many people to take something. And at that concert, I was the only one who got to exchange something physical, an object, I mean. So he took the glasses right out of my hand and I took them back right out of his hand. So it was something that I cherish a lot. I know a lot of other people have that kind of experience with him, with the meet and greets or meeting him in the streets or whatever. I still feel like it's something that I remember all my life. After that, we go to take the picture, the line again. I managed to ask him, do you want to put them on with my glasses? He puts them on over his sunglasses, which is why on my picture you can see a little black outline because his sunglasses were a little bigger. It was super fun because I literally was clutching him like my life. Yeah, you literally see my hand like this on his side, like my life was depending on it. And basically it was. I'm kidding. Tomo next to me managed to get closer, so it was so quick that I didn't really get the time to ask Tomo to come over closer, but he did that, which is a really good thing because I would have been quite sad if he had been like on the side because I was overwhelmed with Jared. Of course, I love Tomo too, I love Shannon, I love the other members who used to be part of the band. Jared has always been someone really important on his own as an artist, as an actor and a singer, and the band in a whole is my favorite band. So I didn't wanna let Tomo on the side on his own. So I'm really glad that he came closer and made a funny face for the picture. What was great was that even if Shannon wasn't there, during the concert when they played City of Angels, Jared went over to where Shannon's drums were supposed to be. There were lights and they talked about how Shannon was stuck in the US for some ridiculous reasons. Well, back then it was with the police, some DUI charges, which in the end ended up being bullshit. Anyway, so it was a long story and it was quite emotional because at one point, you can see in one of the videos that I posted, because I filmed the whole thing, I filmed during the whole concert that I went to, and there's a video of City of Angels where everyone is screaming, "We miss you," and Jared answers, "He misses you too."
Miss you, Shannon!
1, 2, 3!
Miss you, Shannon!
1, 2, 3!
Miss you, Shannon!
He misses you too. Thank you so much.
It was really emotional because it's a song that means a lot to them as brothers, about their mother, about how the city helped them gain their dreams and find joy in life. So it was a really emotional moment. At the end of the concert, when they played Up in the Air and Get Many People on Stage, Jared called one kid, he got him over on the stage. Me and my friends around, we screamed, "Oh my God, that's Noah!" Because Noah, you see, Noah de Costanzo is a Belgian child actor. So he used to play in Mr. Nobody, he plays Little Nemo when he's a child. So he knew Jared from when he was a kid. So he played with him in the same movie. He's from a city really close to mine.
Where's my guy at? Where are you at? See this kid over here? That's young Little Nemo, all grown up. He was the young actor who played me as a child. Tell everybody your name.
Noah.
And tell them where you live.
Moss.
To habit
Belgique.
So it's a really proud thing to have seen him on stage that day when I went there and met them. It was really a proud and touching moment. See him grown up, because he's grown quite well, if you ask me. I'm kidding. He asked Noah to find people to get them on stage, but since we were too far from the stage, he didn't really see us brandishing the sign and the Belgian flag.
Bring some people up on stage for Up in the Air, so you pick up.
So he didn't call us over, but it was still a really great moment to have him on stage when we went there. So all in all, this meet and greet was amazing. It was really brilliant and worth the wait. The only thing was that they were a little late. So they had a concert the day before, I think, in Paris, and the meet and greet started a few hours late. So many people were complaining about it and complaining about Shannon not being there. And in general, the negative aspects of this meet and greet was more related to the people who were paying as fans than to the band themselves, because I didn't really care that much about them being late, because I can understand that their schedule is really, really tight. They have a lot of things to deal with, and they actually are rarely that late for meet and greets. So it was an occasional thing, and the way some people were insulting them and disrespecting them, it was kind of disappointing, but they really made up for it. Jared and Tomo were really kind, they apologized, they were really sweet and generous, they really tried to make the best out of that night. So we were all basically united about Shannon, about our feelings regarding his absence, the fun that we wanted to have that night, about many other things that we share as Echelon and as human beings, I guess. Even if a few negative things happened during the meet and greet or the concert, they really made up for the mistakes. They really were very great and kind, and I'll always be proud of being an Echelon. That day was basically the best day of my life.
Best day of my life!
And I get a little souvenir of that with the picture, but even more thanks to all the things that I shared with the other Echelon. A few days before that, I was in London, where I got some was during my first meet and greet too. It was in the package with the shirt, the poster which was signed, the bag, and the laminate of the VIP badge, like this. So it wasn't just the meet and greet, it wasn't just early entry, the signature, and the photo with them. It was a package with multiple things that you can get back to your home. For this beanie, it was the second time I met them. We had a bag, black, with the symbol of the Monolith Tour. This beanie, a bracelet, this laminate badge with the whole thing, with the symbol, the cross. Some people say it's expensive, but compared to many artists of their fame, like Lady Gaga or Justin Bieber, of course they're more famous around here, but in the US, Jared Leto is someone that's very known even outside of music. So to meet them for only 300 euros or something around that, depending on the package, but this was the lowest package, it's still very cheap if you add all the logistics and the presents, the beanie or shirt, the laminate, the bracelet, the bag, the poster. So most of the things that I have, which are of Mars, I got from the meet and greet packages. So these were gifts I have a necklace, two necklaces actually, that I put in one, which I got on my car. And on my car, I have two stickers that I made myself of the triad. This I bought on the internet. It was not an official one. I used to have earrings too, but I lost one of them. So now I just wear a triangle that a friend offered to me because she noticed that I like triangles. She didn't really know much about why I love this type of triangle. The only official ones that I bought outside of the Meet&Greet packages are these. So this necklace with the plaques, Love, Lust, Faith and Dreams, the logos, their name and Echelon Triad. And this shirt, which I had the first time I went to a concert in Antwerp in 2013. I also made a shirt myself with the triad and the date of my first concert, as you can see here. Nice. I had made the same for a friend of mine, a neighbor who was also a fan back then, but not really an Echelon, as you could say, because she grew out of it. I didn't like it that much, and then we had a fight, so whatever. And I also have a shirt that I bought online, which is literally Jared's face all around the shirt. Like his face with long hair, short hair, from a music video, from a movie he made, from the Oscars. Plenty of Jared Leto's faces all around a shirt, which is quite funny. And I also have a poster of This Is War, which I got as a gift from one of the 20 Belgian Echelon on the bus, and also a Joker poster, which I got when I went to Made in Asia, the convention in Brussels. It's not really related to the band, but it's related to Jared Leto. I have all of the albums so far, two of them which were gifted to me, the deluxe version of Beautiful Lie, which was the first one that I found. So I found a band thanks to Beautiful Lie, which I found randomly on the internet and I fell in love. So I was gifted the first and second albums. I bought This Is War on my own. And then when Love, Lust, Faith and Dreams came out, I bought it too. So yeah, that's all the merch that I have. So all in all, it's an amazing experience, something that you have to do once in a lifetime if you're a fan of this band, or even if you're not, because my mother came with me the second time. She got a cute picture too. I gave her the glasses so that she will wear them on her picture. It was really fun, it's something great. Sometimes you get a bad experience, depending on the day, depending on what happens with the other fans, or with the band, or logistics, or if something goes wrong. But all in all, most people who had a meet and greet with the band, with Jared on his own, or Tomo, or Shannon, or the three of them, they had a good experience, unless they want to focus on the negative, unless they were in a bad mood on their own, or the band was in a bad mood. It's normal too for Jared to be stressed or to have trouble at some point, or to not want to do certain things on the picture. Like I'd asked for me and my mother to be on the same picture, but they didn't agree because some people, like couples, take pictures together and then they break up and then they whine about the picture. So I think that yes, people can have negative experiences about this, but the band are human beings too. And if you can focus on the positive, you always end up happier in the end. So spreading positivity, care, kindness, sweetness, fun, good messages, good values, like the band did for so many years. I think that's the important thing that we can do as Echelon, as fans of the band, as human beings. That was my first story time. Thank you for watching. Don't hesitate suggesting below which topics you want me to talk about, which videos you want me to react to, or which stories you think I could talk about. if you have questions about things that could have happened to me or whatever, really go right ahead and suggest a way below. Don't hesitate giving your opinion too about this video, about what happened. Or if you have also met the band, don't hesitate telling me your story in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Bye!
Sign over here says, please sing a modern myth. Fuck you, no way.
Goodbye. Goodbye. I am finished with you.
Crash.